some important reminders. Number one, no talking. Number two, eyes on your own paper. And last, and no leaving. Any questions?
Mr. Kearns, bro, are we allowed to use the calculator in the test or what?
Right. You do realize it's an English test. Yes, Lauren?
Can I go to the bathroom really quick, please?
Of course you can. Go right ahead. Lauren, wake up. Test is over. Test is over. Lauren, you're all done. Lauren, test is over. Test is over, okay? You can go home now, all right? Hey, test is over. You can go home.
Hi, sorry.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. You've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you.
Talk about family when family's all that we got. Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way.
Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through. That I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began.
You know we
senior. Go.
Stump the senior?
Yeah, just go.
If the temperature is 0 degrees and the next day is 2 times warmer, what temperature is it?
It's pretty warm.
Good answer.
Sure. Zero.
Zero.
What? Zero times two is zero.
Okay.
Can you repeat it?
One.
Isn't that 63 degrees?
Zero?
No.
You said zero?
Nah, that's what he said.
Anything times zero, zero.
No, zero degrees.
Wait, what? Zero Fahrenheit.
Oh, zero, because he said the temperature.
Because if it's 0 Celsius, it's 32 Fahrenheit, and then that makes it 64 degrees Fahrenheit.
Oh.
Oh, can we graduate yet?
I didn't pass the chem exam, so.
I failed like that.
How much stuff can you stuff in a stuffy until your stuffy stuffed enough stuff?
Then you just put the stuff in the stuff, right? And the stuff in the stuff in the stuff.
Teddy bear.
We stuffed how much stuff? All the stuff. All the stuff.
What kind of question is this?
That wasn't the question.
How much?
As much stuff as you want.
A lot of stuff.
Okay.
Until you're really stuffed. How much wood?
Which are good?
No, I'm just kidding. I don't know. Well, I think when you stuff the stuffy, then the stuff should be stuffed because it's called stuffy. Or when if it's unstuffed, then it would be called an unstuffy.
Oh, okay.
Ooh, wise words.
A million.
I'm gonna like just throw out like 20.
Too many.
Way maybe too like 17.
17.
17.
18.
We has a fire alarm.
Yeah, when we has a fire alarm was sent out, it was like the ninth one. Yeah. Nine?
Nine, that's our answer.
At least 10 times, 5 times.
Probably like 38.
38 maybe? Righteous.
8.
I think 10.
I want to say about
I would
8.
Say, I would
I say 8.
Bro, I would say like 50 times, bro. It's been pulled like 50 times, right?
Who are our two assistant principals?
Miss Quay.
Miss Gadges and Miss Quay.
I have no idea.
Did I say it right?
The one that came to talk to us with the PowerPoint.
Miss
Huey? It's Mr. Huddleston.
Miss Huey?
Mr. Huddleston.
Dude, that was last year.
Oh, no.
All right.
What the heck?
All right, it's Miss Huey, and I don't know the other one's name, to be honest. But she caught me leaving once.
Miss Koi
and
Miss
Koi. Koi.
She
know
the way.
Koi.
Isn't it Mr.
Rodriguez?
What?
No.
Is
Miss
Koi? Yeah. Miss Koi. Miss Kiwi.
Gee, bro, you pronounce it Miss Koi.
Oh, it's Miss Koi.
It's Miss Koi.
Miss Koi.
That's an Asian name, bro.
Alright. Go, go. Alright.
Mr. Rodriguez and
What? No.
That one lady,
Miss Block and.
Mr. Capuchino, right?
Gwen.
There are 50 stars on the U.S. flag, each representing a different state. How many states are on the U.S. flag?
50.
There's 50 stars on the California flag. No, not the California flag. I meant to take out the American flag.
50.
How many states are on the U.S. flag? No states. The stars represent the... They states. Represent the states.
The stars are the
There's
states.
No states on the flag.
And then there's 13 lines for the 13 colonies.
Those aren't 13 colonies. They're being represented by the line.
13 is
original colonies.
Okay. 15. I can't tell if I get it right.
It's garbage.
It's supposed to be Tom. What are you doing, son? You're playing the wrong instrument. We're playing Sedona. No, don't put it down.
supposed to be. No, do the E, the E.
Yeah.
No, it's not triplets. It's do today. Do today. Do today.
Wait. Hold on. See? Now you can see me.
Smart Music is due next week, okay? And remember, please practice. I know you don't all practice, but please. Also, we're not a middle school band. We're not a middle school band. Can't be doing this. You guys are mature.
Since we're talking about gender theory, I want to tell you guys a little story that I've been kind of, this is something I've been doing lately. You know, like, this is such a rampant issue that women face every day. So, in order to, like, reverse the roles in a sort of flip script, by the way, that's due on Monday also, I've been going through the streets of San Francisco, Oakland, catcalling men. All right, guys, so I really personally believe in, like, an existential philosophy that I want to let you do your own thing, which is why I'm assigning a 10-page essay that's due on Monday explaining those ideas. Sound great?
Yeah.
Awesome, thank you.
Well, hey, guys, this is my FOA. I'm going to be examining this whiteboard, and there's only one color on here, and that is the color blue.
Looks like class is about to end. Are you guys cool with staying in for brunch so I can explain my ideas? Is that alright?
Of course.
Okay. As a white male. Say it in Spanish? Como un hombre blanco.
Hey, that's not mad. Hey, do your work. Come on. Pay attention, alright? If you don't get off your phone, you're not gonna get into college.
Good afternoon, class. We're going to be learning about the Berlin blockade today. All right, so that's Germany, pretty good. And that's East Germany, right? And then Berlin, perfect, right? Okay. So of course Castro went into the mountains, right? Hey, is anyone actually paying attention? So there was this place in, I think, San Carlos, where they had these pastrami sandwiches. It was $20. But it'll change your life, honestly. It was a really good sandwich.
Yeah, so you know how, like, we're setting Castro and, like, Castro's a dictator? We're like, so is Mr. K.
So, to what extent was Remy from Ratatouille an authoritarian?
Are you okay, Mr. K? You know...
So my friend, he had these, what do you call them? Daughters. Yeah, that's what they're called.
All right.
extra credit points. $1. $20. $100. One camera, right now. No one?
No!
Minus five.
Okay, now Diego, I'm gonna pull you outside. We're gonna have a talk. We're gonna have a nice talk.
Is it because I hate McDonald's?
What happened? All I'm asking is for water. Are you alright?
No.
Are you alright?
No.
You wanna go lighter or deep?
No.
You wanna go both?
No.
Like, I need an apology. Like, how can you go and scream in front of the class and disrespect me?
To be honest, I can't have people like that, okay? Right now, I have to deal with the senior sendoff, I have to deal with this, and then the office, and now I don't know what to do. Okay, I can't have them. Alright?
Yes, I'm sorry, Mr. Shea.
You better, now go to the office. Coming.
Oh, hey, Mr. Shea.
What do you need? Guys, quiet. Silence.
Oh, thank you.
Right now. Anyway, what do you need?
Hey, Mr. Shea. Huh?
Okay.
Hey, Mr. Shea. Mr. Shea!
Mr. Shea!
What? Do you have your popsicle stick up? No! Alright?
Actually.
Outside!
I'm sorry. Okay.
Euclid.
Who else but Pythagoras? First name is Bill.
Euclidean.
That's a good one. There's Greek yogurt. There's Swedish fish.
Euclid.
So I don't even know what that means. Eight?
I think it's that many.
Shakespearean sonnet?
Yeah.
Tucker. Science teachers. Not English teachers.
Let's say 437 or 14.
14, yeah.
Oh,
four.
Deep.
14, right, exactly, 14.
I'm a science teacher, not an English major.
I never got into Harry Potter, but I'd say skip.
My name was Todd. Todd. Final answer.
Already got it wrong. Don't know anything about Harry Potter. We have a Star Wars question.
I can do that. Star Wars.
Owlie? I don't know.
Come with me. Dang it. I forgot. But here's her picture.
Hedwig.
Yeah.
Dubs in Fortnite? Oh, Fortnite. Really? Yeah, dubs. Dubs?
Oh, my dad used to always say this. I would drop some of the recycling and say, get dubs in the Fortnite. I said, Dad, I don't know what you're talking about.
That you won against four opponents?
Fortnite is 2 weeks, so dubs is 2 Wednesdays.
That sounds like something illegal.
Wins? W's?
Pretty sure that's a win.
Dubs is 2 Wednesdays.
I
don't know. What do I look like? A human calculator?
Ten seconds. A square root, carry the one. 15% is not as good as a 20% tip. Oh, $7.
10, 9, 12, 13?
Oh, it's 16.
plus or minus 16.
144 is 12, 169 is 13, 196 is 14, 225 is 15. Final answer, 16.
Cinderella.
Persephone.
Is it really?
Snow White.
Persephone.
That's a princess?
Snow White.
Persephone.
Persephone.
Snow White, probably, like Snow way White. Back in the day, right?
Snow White.
We watched all the Disney movies. I'll go with, I don't know.
Oh, that's a good one, because I remember Tom Hanks was in Princess Bride.
Oh, ooh. Cassius Clay?
Yes.
Cassius Clay, I knew that.
Cassius Clay.
Oh, Cassius Clay.
Cassius Clay.
Really? H? O? R? D? E? A? I don't know.
Probably not gonna get the accents right, I believe. It's like that.
Orsdiver, Orsdiver, O, I forgot the S. H apostrophe O R S D E V O U R. Orsdiver.
H O R S space D apostrophe O E R V E S. Orsdiver.
So close.
Oh!
H. O R S D O U V R E S silent J.
H O R.
That's Orsdiver.
D E V O R E.
Trying to visualize it.
Horses I know ovaries.
No.
there are 100.
Sentence. You can have a lot of people in a senate. It's you're talking about a Honda senate.
100. Wait, people are in the senate. There are.
What is it in the center?
100 senators.
Yes, two from each state. Maybe.
How many people are in the Senate?
Yeah. Right.
I'd have to say three and a half.
No idea.
Is it 11? Let's see here. Maybe 11. If you count Redman, that would be 11. Because it's actually technically correct. He's in a lot of their songs. He's actually on the new round.
Last time I remember is 13.
Wu-Tang.
Khalid.
Location.
Well, she's from the West Coast. Be surprised if it's an East Coast rapper. Tupac might be my first guess.
I would have to go with either Tupac. I'll leave it at that.
No. I don't know. Can I get a light? Can I get like a light?
Yeah. Lifeline?
Yeah. Go with
lifeline?
Yeah, who's a rapper?
Ask me anything.
Who wrote that God's Plan?
Hey.
And you can't tell me?
Drake.
Oh, that would have to be, I think pretty confidently I could say that's Mr. K.
Dress like me? Because I'm the epitome of success.
I would say just enjoy everything about high school because it goes by really fast. Stop getting on your phone and start enjoying the moment. You'll have a better experience.
My advice would be to make sure you challenge yourself and to stay on top of all your assignments because that's something I haven't really been able to do too well.
Bring your best.
Expect success.
Yeah. Alright guys, so one piece of advice that I think is absolutely crucial is that you cannot slack off your senior year. This second semester, it's been incredibly brutal to me. For the past 4 months, I've had straight F's and D's, and I had to work super hard this last month, and guess what? No F's, no D's, only C's, B's, and A's.
Join leadership!
Take IV history. I know IV classes sound really scary, but IV history with Wizard K senior year is totally worth it. And for juniors, take econ over the summer. That way you don't have to do a business project, presentations. Econ over the summer at Skyline was so freaking easy. So do it.
If you're 1 minute late to class, then you can be 25 minutes late to class. Okay, you can go to McDonald's, you can go wherever you want. It's fine.
Okay, one crucial advice, piece of advice that I have for all you underclassmen is to explore different routes throughout your life, regardless of whether or not you think you would like it or not. Like, just basically try a bunch of new things until you find something that you're in love with doing. Invest like so much energy and everything into that passion that you have.
Respect the campus, because no one wants you to be that one person that goes to the bathroom or litters everywhere, because that's annoying and that's really rude. And also respect your teachers, like they're here for a reason. Don't be that butthole.
Remember that everything counts as pass hours. Keep that in mind.
Go to tutoring. It'll save your life.
Cap is going to be your home for a couple of years, so make sure that you make as many friends as possible to make it a great time.
If you're 1 minute late to class, then you can be 25 minutes late to class. Okay, you can go to McDonald's, you can go wherever you want. It's fine.
So my advice is on Wednesdays and Thursdays, if you want to leave for AST and not get caught, the best ways to go is through the football field. Never go through the main office, but the bus loop is pretty good also.
Take care of yourself. You're the most important person in your life. So take care of your mental health, your physical health, and everything about yourself. You come first.
Senior year, you're focused on college and all these deadlines to meet all these important tests. Just take a little time to be happy. Like, do some sports. Go to the beach with some friends, hang out, and just have some fun.
My advice is to be patient. Now, it's gonna suck for like a lot of it, but like we just finished IB exams, like all of them, and it's like the most like relieving feeling in the world. It feels so great. Like in our classes, we just go out and lie on the grass. It's just so nice.
Or really we play, great. Or we play Yu-Gi-Oh.
Or we play Yu-Gi-Oh.
We play cards.
Yes.
If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating. And yet don't look too good nor talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same, if you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken and stoop and build them up with worn-out tools, if you can make one heap of all your winnings and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss and lose, and start again at your beginnings and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except will, which says to them, hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much, if you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it. And, which is more, you'll be a man, my son.
Hi, seniors. You don't know us, but you probably wish you did.
Best of luck to you. Congratulations for everything you guys have accomplished. We're really proud of you, even if we didn't really know you.
I know. Go Go out and go do big things. Wishing you all the best.
All right, class of 2018, congratulations, you made it this far. You always get that high school diploma for endurance more than just performance. So you made it. Congratulations. Now it's time for you guys to go out there and show those colleges what you're made of. And if you ain't going to college, then do something right with yourself, and I can't wait to see what comes out of it. Success in all your endeavors. Good luck, guys. Take care.
Good luck, seniors. Congratulations, and best of luck to you.
Congratulations, class of 2018. I have four things that you need to do. Number one, go away. Just come back. Mom and Dad are here, family's here, and Cat Mustangs are still here. Come see us. Number two, clean up. Your handwriting, your room, your hair, all of it. Clean up. Number three, show up. All the way up, show up. To work, to class, to your life. Number four, do something meaningful. Find it and go after it relentlessly. And because I'm not a math person, I'm an English person, there's actually a fifth one. Hug your mom and kiss your dad. Congratulations, 2018.
Felicitaciones. Por fin se gradúan y va a ser un placer verles en la ceremonia de graduación. Ha sido un placer ser su maestra este año. Son fabulosos. Mis mejores deseos para su futuro y buena suerte.
All right, so my advice to seniors, one of the first things I would say is be ready to spread your wings and fly. Whatever that means for you, it's a personal decision and personal choice. But whatever you do, just stay out of your comfort zone. Try new things, meet new people, travel, explore, do some things that you've never ever done in your life. You will only be young once. Life gets more complicated as you get older. So seize the day, seize your youth while you don't have a lot of additional commitments, and live life to the fullest. Keep God first in your life. Good luck.
Class of 2018, I can't believe you're graduating. It has been so great. It seems like just yesterday that you were like little punkos that would come in, like didn't even have your stuff, didn't do your homework, and now, oh wait. Nothing's changed. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, it is awesome that you are graduating. I am super proud of you, and I wish you all the best. I hope the next few years are even more awesome than they've been at CAP.
Muchas felicidades.
Congratulations, class of 2018.
Bye, seniors. Good luck. Congratulations. Enjoy your lives.
Congratulations, class of 2018. Felicidades a todos for such a great accomplishment. I am beyond proud of everything that you've done, your hard work and effort. A few words of advice that I would have for you as you guys move on to the next step in your lives, in the next chapter, is have fun, you know, enjoy. Take advantage of everything that is on your campus. Meet new people. Join whatever clubs, sororities, fraternities there are. And just enjoy the time. It's going to go by a lot faster than you thought. And travel if you can.
Hi, guys. Congratulations on your impending graduation. I'm so proud of you, and we are going to super miss you. I already miss you this year because I have very few of you. So what wonderful words of wisdom can I impart to you? You already know my feelings about the color green, about plants, about pit bulls, and dogs in general, so I'll skip all of that. I actually have some maybe serious advice for you. Be nicer to yourselves.
Class of 2018, it's been a pleasure working with y'all. My advice, be grateful, help people, travel internationally, and get off your phones and talk to each other.
Class of 2018, my advice, trust me on the sunscreen, look it up.
First of all, congratulations to the class of 2018. The past 4 years have flown by, and I'm so proud that you've reached this milestone. I had to write it out, that's how much thought I wanted to put into this for you. It's a big milestone, but I know it's not the last one. I want to leave you with some advice as you make your way through the next chapters in your life. The first, experience is not what happens to you, it is what you do with it once it happens. As you know, not everything in life glistens and gleams, and there will be times when you feel at your lowest. Don't get stuck there. Learn and grow from it, as it will help you thrive and become a stronger person. Second, the vision will become clearer only when you look into your heart. You have so many outside influences trying to pull you in different directions, from family, friends, significant others, the media, the list goes on and on. While you should listen to the advice being given from all these different directions, it is ultimately you that will make the best decision for yourself. Listen to your heart, follow your gut. Enjoy the next stage of your life. Make smart decisions, like partying hard, but of course, in the library. To the class of 2018, I am so proud of all you have accomplished and look forward to seeing your generation lead. And don't forget, success is determined by how determined you are to succeed.
Congratulations to the class of 2018. Ms. Valletta and I would like to give you a couple words of wisdom. I would like to encourage you to take risks in life, especially in the next 4 years of your life. Take risks, try new things, take classes you wouldn't necessarily have taken, go places you've never been before, meet new people. That's my hope for you all.
Make new friends. Don't decide too early who you are and what you want to do. Don't close any of those doors. Always be looking for things that you could try. Do science, of course, not on your roommate. And we will miss you.
Mm-hmm. To the class of 2018, congratulations and best of luck on your future endeavors. As you go on this next journey in life, just know the road will get bumpy. And expect to hear a bunch of no's and face with many failures. So just take each one as a lesson, learn from it, and grow from it. Congrats again.
Bye bye, I love you.
Go with you, babe. Go with you, babe. Wheeling up my stool, I definitely wouldn't miss a thing. When you rest on your own and you're wondering if I'm following, just know wherever you go, go with you, babe. Go with you, babe. Draw you, that's my lottery one. A gem of the rough, I could be your finishing touch. So wherever you go, go with you, babe, go with you, babe. Wherever you go, go with you, babe, go with you, babe. Shining brightly through a haze, and little slings and arrows, smoke and mirrors, blue and icy meet my gaze. Ooh, my heart breaks light with blood love, slow to get up, hard to save. You fill my head with madness, good and bad, don't be the one who got away. Got away. Where you go, go with your babe, go with your babe. And every night's been without your face has me shuddering. I color my words in a violet shade to have. Go with your babe.
could be your finishing touch. So wherever you go, I'm going with you, babe. Going with you, babe. Wherever you go, I'm going with you, babe. Going with you, babe. Through a haze and little slings and arrows, smoke and mirrors, blue and icy meet my gaze. Ooh, my heart burns like a blood love, slow to get up, hard to save. You fill my head with madness, good and bad, don't be the one who got away, got away. Where you go, I'm going with you, babe, going with you, babe. And every night spent without your face has me shuddering. I color my words in a violet shade to happy pain. So where you go, I'm going with you, babe. Going with you, babe. Where you go, I'm going with you, babe. Going with you, babe.
Forget the good. I won't forget the good.